सो फर्स्ट है मल्टी मॉलिक्यूलर कलॉइड, मल्टी मॉलिक्यूलर. सो अभी यहां पे क्या होता है, मेनी पार्टिकल्स, छोटे छोटे साइज के मेनी पार्टिकल्स आर प्रेजेंट. ओके, एंड दे कम टूगेदर टू फॉर्म वन सिंगल मॉलिक्यूल. दिस पार्टिकल्स कम टूगेदर टू फॉर्म वन सिंगल पार्टिकल. ओके, एक सिंगल पार्टिकल बनाते हैं, बहुत सारे छोटे छोटे मॉलिक्यूल्स गेट एग्रीगेटेड टूगेदर और दे गेट कोएगुलेटेड टूगेदर टू फॉर्म वन सिंगल पार्टिकल. और उसका साइज क्या होगा, कलॉइडल साइज के साथ मैच होगा. दिस साइज विल बी बिटवीन 1 नैनोमीटर to 10^3 नैनोमीटर. ओके ऑल ऑफ यू.
Yes.
So the colloidal particles are aggregates of numerous atoms or a molecule. So colloidal particle are aggregate of numerous atoms or molecules. When many small atoms or molecules comes together, they form a single particle whose size is in range of 1 nanometer to 10^3 nanometer. And this single particle is nothing but a colloidal particle. This single particle is a colloidal particle. Okay. For example, gold sol. A mixture of gold and water forms gold sol. So gold sol is an example of multi-molecular colloids. Silver sol, sulfur sol are examples of multi-molecular colloids. Next is macromolecular colloids. Next is macromolecular colloids.
Ma'am, एक सेकंड, लास्ट स्लाइड दिखाओ ना.
Done,
ma'am.
ma'am, तो example क्या लिखा है?
गोल्ड सॉल, सिल्वर सॉल, सल्फर सॉल.
ओके.
मिस मतलब कि ये जो पार्टिकल्स है ये सब 1 नैनोमीटर से बहुत छोटे हैं, जब ये साथ में आते हैं तब जाके. ओके, थैंक यू.
Hello.
कोक
नेक्स्ट इज मैक्रोमोलिकुलर कलॉइड्स. नाउ इन दिस टाइप्स ऑफ कलॉइड, इन दिस टाइप ऑफ कलॉइड ऐसा कुछ भी नहीं होता है कि सिंगल मॉलिक्यूल्स कम टुगेदर, मेनी सिंगल मॉलिक्यूल्स कम टुगेदर, ऐसा कुछ भी नहीं होता है यहाँ पे. हियर दिस कलॉइडल सिस्टम, दिस कलॉइडल सिस्टम consist of single macro molecule whose size is in range of 1 nanometer to 10 raised to 3 nanometer. एक सिंगल पार्टिकल रहेगा और इसका साइज जो होगा वो किसके बीच में होगा, 1 nanometer to 10 raised to 3 nanometer के बीच में होगा. So macromolecular colloid, macromolecules form true solution, but due to large size, they are colloidal in nature. उनका साइज जो है मींस अट्रैक्शन जो है वो लाइक अ ट्रू सॉल्यूशन है, मींस दे आर कंप्लीटली मिसेबल. ओके, बट सिंस उनका साइज लार्ज है दे आर कलॉइडल सिस्टम. नाउ व्हाट आर द एग्जांपल्स, फॉर एग्जांपल्स हाई पॉलीमरिक मटेरियल, इनऑर्गेनिक सॉल्वेंट. सो दीज आर द वेरियस एग्जांपल्स ऑफ मैक्रोमोलिक्युलर कलॉइड्स. Note it down.
Miss, high polymeric.
High polymeric material in organic solvent. So they form true solution. Means इन लोग mostly क्या होते हैं, lyophilic होते हैं nature में. They are lyophilic in nature. Means there is a attraction between dispersed phase and dispersed medium. Done, all of you?
यस मैम,
यस मैम।
ओके, नेक्स्ट इज एसोसिएटेड कलॉइड्स। ओके, नाउ व्हाट आर एसोसिएटेड कलॉइड? So some substances at lower concentration, they behave normal as strong electrolyte, but at higher concentration they exhibit colloidal behavior, and such colloidal behavior jo particles show karte hai at higher concentration are known as associated colloids or Michels. समझा मैंने क्या बोला? सम सब्सटेंसेस एट लो कॉन्सेंट्रेशन Some substances at low concentration behaves like normal strong electrolyte. But at high concentration, they act as a colloidal solution. Such particles are known as associated colloids. Or they are known as Michels. Or they are known as Michels. Formation of Michels takes place above a certain temperature. Is called Kraft temperature. क्या बोलते हैं इसको? Kraft temperature. Yes, all of you, have you understood? At some particles at low concentration behaves like a strong electrolyte. Strong electrolytes मालूम है ना सबको, they get dissociate completely. But at high concentration, क्या होता है? They comes together, they associate together, and act as a colloidal solution. So such particles are known as associated colloids or Michels. The formation of Michels take place above a certain temperature, and that certain temperature is known as Kraft temperature, which is denoted as TK. It is denoted as TK. Formation of Michels is favored above certain concentration, which is known as critical Michel concentration. Critical इनिशियल कॉन्सेंट्रेशन सीएमसी, क्रिटिकल मिशेल कॉन्सेंट्रेशन। ओके ऑल ऑफ यू, सो व्हेन यू रीड एनसीईआरटी यू विल कम टू नो द वैल्यूज, सीएमसी वैल्यूज। लाइक फॉर सोप, फॉर सोप इट इज बिटवीन 10^-4 टू 10^-3 मोल पर लीटर। ये क्रिटिकल मिशेल कॉन्सेंट्रेशन है। इसके इसके ऊपर वाले टेम्परेचर पे क्या हो, इसके ऊपर वाले कॉन्सेंट्रेशन पे क्या होगा, सोप विल एक्ट एज अ एसोसिएटेड कलोइड्स। यस ऑल ऑफ यू, इज दिस क्लियर?
यस मैम।
नाउ लेट अस स्टडी द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ मिशेल फॉर्मेशन। मिशेल्स फॉर्म कैसे होते हैं? So now suppose if we take the example of soap water, ठीक है? अब soap क्या होता है? सबसे पहले you can see we have already studied this formula of soap in hardness of water, C17H35COONa. Yes, all of you, sodium stearate, you already know this is an soap. तो soap के अंदर कैसा है देखो, it consists of both, this is organic part and this is inorganic part. So ye kaisa hai, non polar nature ka hai aur ye kaisa hai, polar nature ka. This entire part is non polar and this part is polar, means o tak pura. So ye jo sodium hai, it is polar, so it will be hydrophilic na. Water is inorganic, Na is also inorganic, so they both will attract each other. So this is, and this is hydrophobic. हाँ सुन रहे हो कि नहीं सुन रहे हो?
यस
यस
यस मैम।
दिस इज हाइड्रोफोबिक, Na प्लस इज पोलार, इट इज इनऑर्गेनिक एंड दिस इज हाइड्रोफिलिक, ठीक है? अब ये स्ट्रक्चर को इन लोग ऐसे भी रिप्रेजेंट करते हैं लाइक दिस। So this is known as tail and this is known as head. Sodium is known as head and another part C17H35COO-, this is known as tail. ठीक है? Now you can see. अभी suppose तुम्हारे पास में एक cloth है, you have one cloth. Now ye cloth pe oil ka stain hai, this is the stain of oil, this is the stain of oil. Now oil kaisa hota hai all of you, polar hota hai ki non polar hota hai?
Polar.
Polar hota hai?
Non polar.
Oil is non polar. So, अभी नॉन पोलर किसको अट्रैक्ट करेगा? टेल को अट्रैक्ट करेगा कि हेड को अट्रैक्ट करेगा?
टेल
को अट्रैक्ट करेगा ना। नॉन पोलर नॉन पोलर अट्रैक्ट करते हैं, पोलर पोलर अट्रैक्ट करते हैं। तो अभी एक क्लॉथ पे ऑयल है जो कि नॉन पोलर है, अभी इसको मैंने क्या किया, डिटर्जेंट के पानी में डाल दिया। सो नाउ ऑयल विल अट्रैक्ट सोप का टेल, बराबर ना? ये टेल को अट्रैक्ट करेगा, टेल विल बी अट्रैक्टेड विद दिस, मींस टेल इसके साथ बॉन्ड बनाएगा ऑयल के साथ में। बट टेल इज अटैच्ड टू हेड एंड हेड विल अट्रैक्ट वाटर, वाटर के साथ बॉन्ड बनाएगा हेड। यस ऑल ऑफ यू,
यस यस।
वाटर क्या करेगा, हेड को अपनी तरफ खींचेगा, हेड टेल को खींचेगा, टेल ऑयल को खींचेगा, एंड ऐसे करके क्लॉथ पे से क्या हो जाएगा, ऑयल निकल जाएगा. क्लियर ऑल ऑफ यू?
यस मैम.
यस मैम.
एंड ड्यूरिंग दिस प्रोसीजर मिशेल गेट्स फॉर्म. जितने भी डिटर्जेंट के पार्टिकल्स है ये सारे ऑयल पे क्या हो गए है, अटैच्ड हो गए, एंड दिस टुगेदरली इट इज फॉर्मिंग अ मिशेल. दिस इज अ मिशेल, दे हैव कम टुगेदर एंड दे आर फॉर्मिंग मिशेल. दिस इज क्लियर ऑल ऑफ यू?
यस सर.
सो यू विल राइट दिस इन योर ओन वर्ड. अभी जो मैंने तुम लोग को समझाया. And during formation of micelle, cleaning action takes place. Cleaning of clothes take place. So, just note it down all of you and write down the mechanism what I have explained to you in your own.
Ma'am,
words.
Hydrophilic head mein COO minus bhi hai na?
नहीं, सिर्फ Na आता है वो वहां पे वैसा दिया है, बट सिर्फ Na प्लस जो है वो ही हाइड्रोफिलिक है, बाकी का पूरा पार्ट जो है वो हाइड्रोफोबिक है.
यस मैम, अंडरस्टूड. Can you show associated collides page? Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, all of you, this is done. Now pay attention here. Yes, all of you. So, let's have some changes. इसमें हम लोग को add करना है अभी जो I think मल्हार ने पूछा था मुझे question. This part is non-polar and hydrophobic, and since it is having charge, so it will also be it will come under hydrophilic part. Okay, so ye jo entire part hai wo head hai. And ye jo hai wo tumhara tail hai. Theek hai? Yes, all of you.
Yes ma'am.
Samjha maine kya bataya?
Yes ma'am.
So ye see you have C17 H35 COO minus Na. So when this is soap, when it will go in water, it will get dissociated into C17 H35 COO COO minus plus Na plus. ठीक है, फिर ये जो पार्ट है इसके अंदर C17H35COO-. This part is non-polar. Okay? Because it don't have charge. तो ये देखो, ये जो स्ट्रक्चर है यहाँ तक, ये कैसा है, ऐसा है ना टेल के जैसा zigzag. So ये वो पूरा पार्ट है, और ये जो COO- है ये पार्ट, this is polar part. Clear all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
हो गया?
Yes.
So now preparation of colloids. So chemical formation of colloids. First method is chemical formation. So we have arsenic oxide. When we add it in H2S, it will have double decomposition. So यहाँ पे क्या होगा? AS2S3 बनेगा जो कि सॉल है प्लस वाटर. ओके, सो आर्सेनिक सल्फाइड का सॉल बनेगा वाटर के साथ में. SO2 plus H2S, it will undergo oxidation, and sulfur plus water ka salt banega. This is the salt. You have gold chloride plus formaldehyde plus water. You will have reduction. Reduction reaction होगा यहाँ पे, gold बाहर आ जाएगा and formic acid बनेगा plus acid. So this is a salt, gold salt. FeCl3 plus water will undergo hydrolysis. It will form FeOH thrice plus HCl. There will be a salt of ferric hydroxide. Okay, all of you. Likh lo isko fast.
फर्स्ट रिएक्शन में प्रोडक्ट क्या है?
क्या क्या किसमें?
फर्स्ट रिएक्शन में प्रोडक्ट मींस वो AS है, AS2S3।
हाँ, आर्सेनिक सल्फाइड। It's done, all of you.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Now, next is preparation of colloids by electrical disintegration or Briggs arc method. So, iska main video batati hu tum log ko. Yes, all of you, have you understood this?
Ma'am, आवाज ही नहीं है.
Yes.
आवाज नहीं आई. ये दिख आ रही है आवाज?
हाँ, ये आ रही है.
एक मिनट में स्टार्टिंग से लगाते हैं.
Metals like gold, silver, platinum, etc. The method uses two rods of metal which are going to disperse as electrodes. These rods are immersed under the dispersion.
Now suppose तुम्हें गोल्ड का सॉल्व बनाना है, then you will take this electrode. Which electrode? गोल्ड का इलेक्ट्रोड लोगे तुम लोग.
In this case, water along with some stabilizing agent like potassium hydroxide. The whole setup is placed inside an ice bath or cold bath. The ice mixed with a little salt to make sure the ice doesn't melt so fast. The ice bath ensures the water remains cold. When the electrodes are charged using electricity, an arc is formed at the end. Due to the arc, a huge amount of heat is generated, causing the metal to vaporize. Since the water is
still... Yes, all of you, have you understood this? इतना ज्यादा इलेक्ट्रिसिटी पास किया है कि जिसके वजह से क्या हुआ, मेटल जो है वो क्या हो गया, सॉलिड से गैस में चला गया, वेपर्स बने. एंड सिंस दैट वाटर इज वेरी चील्ड, तो वो वेपर्स क्या हो जाते हैं, कंडेंस हो जाते हैं, तो वो वेपर जो है वो लिक्विड में कन्वर्ट होके वो उसके अंदर मिक्स हो जाता है. बट वो जो मिक्स होता है दैट इज पार्शियली मिक्स, एंड दैट्स व्हाई इट फॉर्म अ कलॉइड.
Condenses back to solid and disperses to form the colloidal solution.
Yes, all of you, have you understood this?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So just you can write down this, all of you. इसको अपने ओन वर्ड्स में लिख लो फास्ट. Yes, all of you, have you written it?
Yes.
It's just one. Yes, miss.
Yes, all of you, third process is peptization process. So peptization process kya hai? It is a process in which precipitate, jo precipitate form hua hai freshly in colloidal solution, to usme kya karenge? Abhi suppose you have a solution. You have a solution. Uske andar yahan pe precipitate form hua hai. Theek hai? Now what I will do, I will add electrolyte in it. So electrolyte add karne pe kya hota hai? Ye precipitate jo form. Now what is precipitate, all of you? Jo dissolve nahi hota hai solution ke andar, wo precipitate banata hai. Barabar na? But when you add electrolyte, precipitates get soluble in dispersed medium. And by this way, colloid is formed. And that electrolyte is known as peptizing agent. So hota kya hai actually? So ye electrolyte yane kya hota hai? Charge particles hote hai, barabar. Abhi ye atom hai, precipitate ka atom hai. Wo kya kar lega? Electrolyte ko apne upar adsorb kar lega. To abhi ye charge ho gaya. Yes, all of you. Now it has become charged. Aur fir ye kya करेगा? डिस्पर्स मीडियम के साथ में बॉन्ड बना लेगा. दिस इज क्लियर? सो विथ हेल्प ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोलाइट्स, डिस्पर्स फेस एंड डिस्पर्स मीडियम एक दूसरे के अंदर क्या हो जाते हैं? डिसॉल्व हो जाते हैं, बॉन्ड्स बना लेते हैं, एंड दैट इज नोन एज पेप्टाइजेशन. क्लियर ऑल ऑफ यू? बोलो. So let's write down what is peptization, all of you. The process in which precipitate are dissolved in solution by adding electrolytes are called peptization. The electrolytes used in this process is known as peptizing agent. During this process, dispersed phase, or you can say precipitate, क्या करता है? Adsorbs electrolytes. Dispersed phase adsorbs electrolytes on the surface. Due to which surface of dispersed phase gets charged and it makes bond with dispersed medium and therefore it gets soluble in dispersed medium. Is this clear, all of you?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Write down this fast.
Miss, okay, likha, it gets soluble in.
कहाँ लिखा है कहाँ पे ऊपर
लास्ट लाइन एकदम लास्ट
लाइन डिस्पर्स मीडियम Yes, all of you, it was done, na?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, yes. Next is purification of colloids. Okay? Colloids mein kuch impurity rehta hai, toh usko kaise purify karne ka? So, first process hai dialysis.
Solutions. The process used for reducing the amount of impurities to a requisite minimum is known as purification of colloidal solution. The purification of colloidal solution can be done by following methods. Dialysis. It is a process of removing a dissolved substance from a colloidal solution by means of diffusion through a suitable membrane. The apparatus used for this purpose is called dialyzer. Electrodialysis. The process of dialysis is quite slow. It can be made faster by applying an electric field if the dissolved substance in the impure colloidal solution is only an electrolyte. Then the process is known as electrodialysis. Ultrafiltration. In this method, colloidal solutions are purified by carrying out filtration through special type of graded filters called ultrafilters. These filter papers allow the electrolytes to pass through them but do not allow colloidal particles.
Yes, all of you, have you understood this?
Yes.
Purification of colloidal solutions.
If anyone is not able to understand, just tell me.
Bangal Baba, Space Baba, Bengali Baba, Bhua, Tantrik, Natpanthi. Kaun se Baba ke darshan karengi?
Flood Baba.
Purification of colloidal solution. During the preparation of colloidal solution, excessive electrolytes and some other impurities remain in the colloidal solution. These impurities can be removed by dialysis, electrodialysis, and ultrafiltration. Dialysis. Here, impurities are removed by diffusion by using suitable membrane. A vessel where fresh water is continuously flowing. A membrane containing colloidal solution is suspended in the vessel. The membrane contains small pores. From these pores, small impurities and electrolytes get diffused from the solution to water, but large colloidal particles remain within the solution. From these pores, small impurities and excess electrolytes get diffused to water and removed. Pure colloidal solution left within the membrane. Electrodialysis. Dialysis is a slow process. To make this process faster, electric field is applied. This method is used when impurities are electrolytes. Electrolytes are positively or negatively charged. When electric field is applied, these electrolytes are attracted
Have you understood this? What is dialysis?
Yes,
ma'am.
So in dialysis, abhi dialysis normally jo hota hai wo slow process hai. You can see the diagram. So isko fast karne ke liye hum log kya kar sakte hai? Electrodes laga sakte hai dono side pe, jaise pehle video mein bataya tha. So जब भी हम लोग इलेक्ट्रोलाइट्स लगाएंगे तो अगर सपोज तुम्हारा इम्प्योरिटी नेगेटिव है तो वो क्या करेगा, पॉजिटिव इलेक्ट्रोड को अट्रैक्ट करेगा, मीन्स वो मेम्ब्रेन में से बाहर आ जाएगा एंड इट विल गेट वॉश ऑफ विद द हेल्प ऑफ वॉटर. दिस इज क्लियर ऑल ऑफ यू?
मेम्ब्रेन लगा है तो वो इसमें जैसे कि वो पिंक कलर का लिक्विड है वो बाहर नहीं आ रहा
क्योंकि वो तो कलोइड है ना, तो उसके अंदर क्या था, वो जो बैक वो जो मेम्ब्रेन था उसके अंदर तीन टाइप के पार्टिकल्स थे, एक तो कलोइड्स था, एक इलेक्ट्रोलाइट्स था और एक इम्प्योरिटी था. जो तो मेम्ब्रेन के जो पोर्स होते हैं वो बड़े साइज का पार्टिकल्स को बाहर नहीं आने देते, छोटे पोर्स होते हैं तो छोटे साइज के पार्टिकल्स ही सिर्फ बाहर आते हैं.
ओके समझा.
दिस इज क्लियर ऑल ऑफ यू? एंड टू मेक दिस फास्ट, यहाँ पे क्या करेंगे हम लोग, इलेक्ट्रोड्स लगा सकते हैं नेगेटिव एंड पॉजिटिव. अभी सपोज इम्प्योरिटी नेगेटिव है तो पॉजिटिव इलेक्ट्रोड लगा देने का, तो पॉजिटिव इलेक्ट्रोड क्या करेगा, वो अट्रैक्ट करेगा ना इम्प्योरिटी, तो फास्ट बाहर आएगा एंड देन इट कैन बी रिमूव्ड आउट. दिस इज क्लियर ऑल ऑफ यू? राइट दिस बोथ मेथड्स इन योर ओन वर्ड फास्ट. You can also draw the diagram. Write it fast.
Thank you.
Yes, all of you, is it done?
Yes.
Ultrafiltration. Yes, all of you, ultrafiltration. Ultrafiltration, all of you. सो अल्ट्राफिल्ट्रेशन में भी वहां पे तुम लोग ने वीडियो में देखा रहेगा क्या होगा वहां पे अल्ट्राफिल्ट्रेशन में एक मेम्ब्रेन लगाते हैं एंड दैट मेम्ब्रेन इज हैविंग वेरी स्मॉल पोर्स दे आर अल्ट्रा स्मॉल पोर्स ओके एंड वो पोर्स के थ्रू से सिर्फ इम्प्योरिटी बाहर निकलेगा एंड दैट इज नोन एज अल्ट्राफिल्ट्रेशन ओके ऑल ऑफ यू Now next is the properties of colloids. So let us do some general properties of colloids first. So colloid, colloid kya hai? Ek heterogeneous mixture hai. Correct na? All of you?
Yes.
Colloids are heterogeneous mixture. And it consists of dispersed phase and dispersed medium. Dispersed phase passes slowly through parchment membrane. Parchment membrane yani kya membrane which is made up of skin of animals or vegetables it passes readily through filter paper It cannot be detected from powerful microscope. The color of salt depends on size of salt particles. For example, gold salt changes its color from red to blue depending on size. Okay, all of you, is this clear to all? Note down it fast.
हम फोर्थ पॉइंट में cannot be के बाद क्या लिखा है?
Cannot be detected.
Miss,
yes,
Miss, what you written before gold, gold stole?
For example, yes, all of you, what was the homework given to you?
State level 1 to 19, concept application exercise 1 and 2.
Okay. ये हो गया सबका?
Yes, ma'am.
So now first we'll discuss the optical property. Now optical property is explained with help of Tyndall effect. Okay, so let us see what is Tyndall effect.
Objective: to learn the concept of Tyndall effect. The Tyndall effect, named after physicist John Tyndall, involves the scattering of light by finely suspended particles in something such as pin colloid. This effect is also referred to as Tyndall scattering. Let's demonstrate the Tyndall effect. We'll begin by filling all three beakers with the distilled water. In the first, we'll leave just the water. In the second, we'll dissolve a spoonful of sugar. And in the other, we'll stir a few drops of milk. First, we'll shine through the beaker containing only the water. Although we cannot see the light beam as it is passing through the water, we'll be able to see it as it emerges unchanged from the other side. Now we'll shine our laser through the second beaker containing the sugar solution. Once again, we cannot see the beam as it passes through the solution, but we are able to see it as it emerges from the other side, again unchanged. Finally, we'll shine our laser through the third beaker, which has milky water. In this case, we are able to clearly see the light beam as it passes through the liquid. This appearance of a light beam passing through a liquid is the result of Tyndall effect. What is happening to the light beam? Let's take a closer look at what's in each beaker so that we'll have a better understanding. In distilled water, any particles are too small to obstruct the path of light as it passes through, meaning we won't be able to see the beam. A solution, such as a sugar solution we made, is a homogeneous mixture made up of only one phase. In this form, the solute, in this case the sugar, will dissolve in the solvent, in this case the water, and take on the characteristics of the solvent, meaning once again we won't be able to see the light hitting anything. A colloid, however, has two phases: the dispersed phase, which is the milk particles, and the dispersion medium, which is the water. In the colloid, light will scatter in different directions due to the dispersed particles. But in water and in true solutions, such as a sugar solution, it will pass through without being scattered. The Tyndall effect is used in identifying whether a liquid is a solution or a colloid. Summary: the Tyndall effect involves the scattering of light as it passes through a colloid. True solutions do not exhibit the Tyndall effect.
Yes, all of you, have you understood? And I think this you have already done in school also.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
So write whatever you have understood for a Tyndall effect. I did fast. Done. Yes, it's done, all of you.
Done.
Next is kinetic property. Next property is kinetic property, which is explained by Brownian movement. So Brownian movement is what we'll have it in video.
Motion. This is useful because it helped indirectly to confirm that atoms exist. You're in a darkened room, the air is still, and the bright lights are streaming through the window. What do you notice about the dust particles? The black circles as they pass through the beam of light. Pause the video and think about this. Press play once you've made up your mind. The answer is that the dust particles are moving randomly. Did you see it? The dust particles are not always moving downwards, but are moving in all directions. The dust particles are very small and are supported by a fluid. In this case, that fluid is a gas. You are unable to see the gas particles directly because they are too small, but you can see the larger dust particles. The reason that the dust particles move randomly are because of the gas. We know that the gas is there because every time we move our hand through the air, we feel them against our hand. Try it now. Continue when ready. The particles in the air move in random directions quickly. This means they will have many collisions or will bump into the dust particles many times. Each collision between air particles, very small coloured circles, show how the dust particle, the black circle, moves off in a new random direction. It's a bit like a game of snooker, where there are millions of marbles which collide with larger, observable particles like a ping pong ball. This effect was first observed by scientist Robert Brown. He was looking at pollen grains suspended in water under the microscope, and he wondered why they jiggled around. He thought that the pollen was alive. It was later that scientists realized the importance of his discovery. Now, here's a challenge for you. Thinking about what we know about dust particles, can you explain why the pollen grains appear to be jiggling randomly? Pause the video and continue when ready. In summary, the fluid is no longer a gas, but is a liquid, water. The pollen grain is colliding with many water molecules. Each water molecule is too small to see, but we can see the combined effect of their collisions on the pollen grain as it moves randomly. This effect is known as, you guessed it, Brownian motion.
Yes, all of you, have you understood Brownian movement? Yes. So we have seen many times na Brownian movement when car ke headlight ke samne we can see dust particles moving in air, because dust and air is a colloidal mixture. So we can see dust particles moving in all direction randomly. है ना, डिस्पर्स फेस के पार्टिकल्स आर लार्जर इन साइज देन दैट ऑफ डिस्पर्स मीडियम. लार्ज साइज में होने के वजह से दे आर हैवी, दे हैव लेस काइनेटिक एनर्जी. डिस्पर्स मीडियम पार्टिकल्स आर स्मॉलर इन साइज, दे हैव मोर काइनेटिक एनर्जी. एंड व्हेन दे कोलाइड विद डिस्पर्स फेस पार्टिकल, काइनेटिक एनर्जी क्या हो जाता है, ट्रांसफर हो जाता है मीडियम से फेस में. एंड देन डिस्पर्स फेस क्या करता है, अपना डायरेक्शन चेंज कर देता है. एंड दैट इज नोन एज अ ब्राउनियन मूवमेंट. क्लियर ऑल ऑफ यू?
यस.
राइट डाउन ब्राउनियन मूवमेंट इन योर ओन वर्ड्स. राइट इट फास्ट. It's done, all of you. Dan?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so all of you will stop here. We'll stop here and we'll continue with electrical properties in next lecture. Okay?
Thank you, ma'am.
So your homework, PDF solve karna hai, jo main abhi bhejungi next lecture mein.